This is Halima with the Floral Guru, and today we're going to be doing something a little bit different. I'm going to be showing you a nice, easy, beginner-friendly tutorial to make this gorgeous floral runner. This floral runner is perfect for a dinner party that you're having at home or a wedding. It's great for sweetheart area tables or even guest tables. So it's a really versatile design. If you're interested in knowing exactly how many hydrangea and how many roses we use, just click the link below to get the free floral count sheet. And if you're interested in learning how to design this beautiful backdrop, you can also click the link in the description to get the tutorial for that. So this is going to be a really easy beginner-friendly tutorial, and you're just going to need 5 things. The first one is some chicken wire. Now this is what chicken wire looks like. It comes in a big roll, and I like to buy the plastic chicken wire. There is a metal type of chicken wire, but I don't like working with it because it can cut you. The next thing that you're going to need is some floral foam. So you can get this at any floral store. You can also buy this on Amazon. And as much as possible, I will link the items that I'm using down in the description box. I'm just using some Advantage Oasis foam, but any type of floral foam really should be able to work for this design. The next thing that you're going to need are some flowers. Today I'm going to be using a mix of some silk flowers as well as some fresh flowers. So I have some silk hydrangea and I have some fresh roses. I love mixing fresh and silk flowers because the silk flowers give you a lot of volume in your design. And the very last thing you're going to need are some zip ties. Again, you can find this at Home Depot or any home goods store. I like to use the little tiny ones, and again, as much as possible, I will link the items that I'm using down in the description box. To start your design, you're going to want to create what I call a sausage with your foam and your chicken wire. So you're going to cut your chicken wire to the size of the design that you're making, so just based on the table that you're designing with. And what you're going to do is wrap your chicken wire around your foam and secure it with zip ties. That this is the complete piece of sausage. As I mentioned, all we did was take some Advantage Plus foam, wrap it in plastic chicken wire, and then add some zip ties along the way. Once you have that done, you're going to have a piece that looks like this, and this is what I like to call your sausage. And from here, it really is very easy, guys. So all you're doing is adding in your biggest flowers first. In my case, I'm adding in hydrangea. And what you want to do is make sure that you are covering the design from all angles. So you want some flowers at the top, you want some on the side, and you want to have a little bit of variety in the height so that not all of your flowers are, you know, the exact same height. I'm just adding in all of my silk flowers into my design, making sure that I'm getting all of the spaces covered. And this is probably going to be much easier for you to do at home because you're not trying to kind of film it at the same time. So what's going to be important for you to note is that when you get to the end of your design right here, you're going to want to stick the flowers outwards so that you're covering all of your mechanics. So let me show you what that looks like really quickly. So this is the end of my design, and I'm just going to stick the flowers out so that we're covering the mechanics on that end. Done with my silk hydrangea, I'm going to go in with my silk roses before I go in with my fresh roses. The fresh roses are really going to be the last item that I add into this design. And so again, the exact same way that I added the hydrangea in, I'm going to be adding my silk roses. So as you can see, your design is already looking really beautiful and really full. And if you are interested in knowing how many stems I used for this design, you can click the link in the description box and I will send you a free floral count sheet. If you're also interested in learning a little bit more about this beautiful backdrop that we have, there's also a link in the description box for a tutorial on that. It's really cool and it's perfect for any wedding or ceremony that you have coming up. And just like this tutorial, it's pretty beginner friendly. So just like that, I am done adding my silk hydrangea and my silk roses. And now what I'm going to add in are my fresh flowers. These roses are called Vandella, and because we're not going to wet the foam, what you want to do instead is to use water tube. And here is a close-up of what the water tubes look like. And then you're just going to go in and add your fresh flowers to your design, similar to how you did the rest of this. Just like that, you are all done with your design. Again, if you're interested in knowing exactly how many hydrangea and how many roses we use, just click the link below to get the free floral count sheet. And if you're interested in learning how to design this beautiful backdrop, you can also click the link in the description to get the tutorial for that. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next week.